Hey guys, welcome back. This is Sumit Kumar. कैसे हैं आप लोग? और आज जो मैं टॉपिक बताने वाला हूँ आपको, उसमें मैं तीन चीजों की चर्चा करूँगा. एक countable, uncountable, and when we say two sets have same cardinality. Okay? So this question is partly about that. You know, कोई भी आप exam दो, doesn't matter net दो, gate दो, jam दो, TFR दो, right? तो क्या होता है कि जहाँ पे हमें कार्डिनल नंबर्स टाइप की चीज है कि दो सेट की कार्डिनलिटी सेम दिखानी है, या किसी सेट को अनकाउंटेबल प्रूव करना है, या किसी सेट को काउंटेबिलिटी आंसर देना है, तो हम लोग हमेशा कंफ्यूज हो जाते हैं. वी आर ऑलवेज टोटली ब्लैंक. वी डोंट नो हाउ टू प्रोसीड दैट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन, हाउ वन शुड थिंक दैट दोस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू रिड्यूस योर दैट बर्डन, ओके, योर दैट हेडिंग, सो दैट यू विल फील हैप्पी इन ऑल एग्जाम्स. See, unless you will not work hard, it's not going to worth it. So at the same time, you have to also work hard, you have to read, and what do you mean by bijection, one function, one two function, you should know. I can't do everything in the video, right? I can expect that you are also going to work hard that much, okay? My goal is to make you comfortable in mathematics. If you want, if you don't want, to koi nahi kuch kar sakta aapke liye. रामानुजन भी आ जाएंगे तो भी उन्हें कुछ कर पाएंगे. क्लियर हुआ मेरी बातचीत? तो आपके अंदर वो जज्बा होना चाहिए. इफ यू विल ट्राई देन डेफिनेटली इट विल हैपन, बट इफ यू नॉट ट्राई देन इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन. सो इट्स अप टू यू, एंड आई नो यू वांट टू ट्राई, यू आर ट्राई, राइट? आई एम राइट? सो दैट्स व्हाट यू हैव टू डू. सो लेट्स सी. सो दिस पार्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट दोज थ्री कॉन्सेप्ट, एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डू वन बाय वन. Okay, so let's come to the question directly. Okay, so question here is, consider the following set of functions, okay, on R. Okay, so consider the following set of functions on R. What is the W? W is the set of constant functions on R. X is the set of polynomials on R. Y, the set of continuous functions on R. And Z is the set of all functions on R. Okay, so let's try to understand what are those questions. W is nothing but the set of constant functions on R. X is nothing but the set of polynomials on R. And Y is the set of continuous functions on R. And Z is the set of all functions on R. Which of the following set has the same cardinality as that of R? That's what they are talking about, right? Which of the following set has the same cardinality as that of R? First option is only W. Second option is only W and X. Third option is only W, X and Z. And last option is all W, X, Y, Z. All are right. So it's simple, right? First they are saying W is the set of all continuous constant functions on R. X is set of all polynomials. Y is set of all continuous functions. Z is set of all functions on R. Then, इसमें से ये चार सेट में से किसकी कार्डिनलिटी किसके बराबर? R के बराबर है. वो आपको चेक करना है, वो आपको ऑप्शन दिया हुआ है. तो पहले आपको यहाँ पे दो कीवर्ड्स हमें मिल रहे हैं. कौन कौन? कार्डिनलिटी किसका? R का. तो आपको पता होना चाहिए. तो इस टाइप के क्वेश्चन को हम लोग कैसे प्रोसीड करें, इस टाइप के क्वेश्चन को हम लोग कैसे सोचें जब कोई भी सेट दे दिया है, पॉलिनोमियल्स दे दिया है, कॉन्स्टेंट फंक्शन दे दिया है, कंटिन्यूस फंक्शंस दे दिया है, ऑल फंक्शंस दे दिया गया है, सबका कार्डिनलिटी पूछ रहा है, कैसा हम लोग अप्रोच करेंगे? ऐसा आता है तो लोग कन्फ्यूज हो जाते हैं ना. मैं भी कन्फ्यूज होता था जब मैं पढ़ता था तो, बिकॉज आई वॉज नॉट गेटिंग दैट गाइडेंस. बट ओके, दैट हैपेंड टू मी, बट इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन टू यू, आई प्रॉमिस दैट. ओके, सो लेट्स सी हाउ टू अप्रोच दिस. How to take care, right? That's important. How one should approach. So recall, what do you mean by cardinality of a set? You know, cardinality of a set is very important. So cardinality, basic term है, अपने आम भाषा में बोले तो size of a set. For example, अगर कोई set है, let's say if I'm writing this set, ABC. I am asking what is the cardinality. Cardinality of this set means what is the size. Size means here is what is the number of elements here. So number of elements A here is 3. 3. Sometimes notation for cardinality is also use this, okay, that vertical bar, or sometimes this. These are all this, and if you are on group theory, you know, order of A, something like that. Everyone is, that depends in which book you are following. So this sometimes you find in some standard book, this also you can find, that's also you can find, that depends, doesn't matter, that's not important. Okay, other question, set room D here, 1, 2, 3. Are these two sets have the same cardinality? Yes, here you have 3 elements, here you have 3 elements. So we say if they have the same cardinality, means they are equivalent. So what do you mean by this? If I write this, means these two sets are equivalent, means they have the same cardinality. Same cardinality in the sense there exists a bijection from A to B. So these are the some definition you should know. And how you can know? You go back, learn any basic book or either real answers or in abstract algebra you can also find in set theory. So go back. That's not a crime. Pause the video, go back. And learn from what do you mean by equivalency of two sets, and what do you mean by two sets are the same cardinality, and then come back, then you should know. Okay, so this is the basic rough idea given. Whenever cardinality word they are using, cardinality means always understand in the mota moti bhasha mein size of the set, right? Size. This is not saying that this is the rigorous definition or classical definition. This I'm saying rough definition. This is the motivation, size of a set. Okay. Now let's remove this. So this thing you should know. Now I have to think here something. Okay. Now W is nothing but the set of all set of constant functions. Where? On R. So koi function hai R to R is constant if there exists one naught belongs to y such that f of x is equal to y naught for all x belongs to R. Okay, so if you give me any function from to R, that function is said to be constant function if there exists a y naught belongs to y such that f of x is equal to y naught for all x belongs to R. So means every function is uniquely determined, every constant function is uniquely determined for a given value of y naught. So once you give me y naught, I will give you function f, and if you give me constant function, I will give you the y naught. So y naught is nothing but the set containing y naught is nothing but the range of f, right? So what your intuition says, how many such functions is going to be? Tell me, how many such functions is going to be? Any functions, there exists a unique y naught. Once you have y naught, you are going to get, see this y, sorry, this y belongs to R. So, for a given real number, I have a function, and once you have a constant function, I have a real number. So, this is one of the correspondence. So, that means your W is equivalent to Y. So, again, I am writing Y. Sorry. It's R. Okay? So, tick. So, W is equivalent to R. Why? Every function you can correspond to Y naught. For given F, Y naught, Y naught, F. So that's depend on y naught. So if you change the y naught, function will change. If you change the function, y naught is going to be. So this is 1 and on 2 from w to r. So y is equivalent to r. Hence there exists a bijection from w to r. That bijection, that's exactly that bijection. Hence they have the same cardinality. So w ki jo cardinality hai, wo kiske barabar hai? R ke barabar hai. That's what we have proved. Okay? Happy? Okay. Next, let's move on. Now, what about the X? So what is X? X is nothing but the collection of polynomials. The set of polynomials, functions. Kidhar? R. Polynomials. So, jo bhi polynomial hai R mein, polynomials on R matlab coefficients are from real number. So any polynomial in R, If that is a constant polynomial, then of course degree is 0, and if it is non-constant, then degree is greater than or equal to 1. and 0 degree polynomial is by default, that degree is not defined but still we can consider on that. ठीक है ऐसे तो कोई भी आप polynomial दोगे उसका कुछ ना कुछ degree होगा. So that means I can write this union of Px Pn where Pn is set of all polynomials of degree exactly where A I is belongs to a real number and I is from 0 to 1. So this is a vector space of all polynomials of degree less than equal to n. And this is the vector space and the dimension of this vector space is n plus 1. So by linear algebra this is isomorphic to as a vector space Rn plus 1 over the field R. So this is this and this is isomorphic to this, but this set is equivalent to R. I am not giving this is isomorphism right now, I am not giving, but I can give also, but this set is equivalent to this set. How? What is the cardinality of Rn plus 1? Cardinality of Rn plus 1 is nothing but cardinality of R is what? Continuum and iska power n plus 1. See, that's again the algebra in cardinal numbers. If you add the same cardinal numbers that times you will get the that number. If you multiply finitely many times the same cardinal number, you will get the exactly same cardinal number. So that's nothing but C. Okay, that's the theory from cardinal numbers. So you can do that. See, if I write the theory of cardinal numbers, it will take a lot of time. So I request you, you should go back and learn that cardinal number theory. If you don't know, it's okay. That's not a crime. I'll do it here. Okay? Fine. So this. And this is nothing but cardinality of R. Hence, we will have a bijection from Rn to R. So this is equivalent to R. So what we have proved? Pnx has same cardinality as that of R for each n. For each n greater than equal to 0. So each n, Pnx is equivalent to R and this is the countable union and the cardinality of this is same as the cardinality of R. So this set is equivalent to R. Hence X and R have same number of, they have the same cardinality. That's what they are saying, have the same cardinality. So X is same. Okay. How I have done? You have given me all polynomial set. I have written this as a countable union of this. And this has the cardinality as R. So by again set theory, this has cardinality because this is a countable union of such kind of sets and each one has cardinality as R. Again apply your set theory concept. This has the same cardinality as of R. So good. Okay? So this. Okay. Now let's come to the why. Why you have given me nothing but the set of continuous functions on R? Set of continuous functions on R. Iska matlab kya hai? Such that f is continuous. That's what, right? That's what you have given. Set of all continuous functions from R to R. Okay. Ek chiz aapne note kar diya. Now let me define a set. On those f q to r such that f is continuous. Let me write this set first. First let me write this. Why I have written? I'll tell you right now. First thing note is, note that if f belongs to y, that implies f belongs to a. If f is continuous over r, then f of course be continuous on rational number. If I restrict to that to rational number, since f restricted to q is continuous on q, if f is continuous on r, right? This is a theory. If you have a bigger domain x, if you have a function from x to y and you have a subset of x, let's say a, and you have a function f from x to y, then if you restrict to that function to A, then that if that function is continuous, then restriction of that function is also continuous. How this is coming? That's called subspace topology concept. So use that, it's going to be continuous. Okay, fine. So every function from here, you have a function from here, that's the same induction. Okay, okay. Now, so what? I mean, what is the useful of this? I'll tell you later. So this is clear. If you have an element here, you will get an element here. A bit, I have to show that no. For each element, you will have a unique element. Means Y you can view as a subset of A. How I can view Y as a subset of A? If somehow I can give an 1-1 map from Y to A. I'm not saying Y is a subset of A. I'm saying I can view Y is sitting inside A. For that, I have to give injective map from Y to A. How I can give that I am going to explain, and now I will prove that A is, cardinality of A is going to be R. How I can show? Right now I will show it. Okay, let me erase first. Okay, let me define one set B. B is nothing but the set of all functions from Q to R. That's nothing but R to the power Q. So R to the power Q means set of all functions from Q to R. So what is the cardinality? So cardinality of your script B is nothing but cardinality of R and cardinality of rational number. That's nothing but LF naught. These are the some standard notation you should know. What is the cardinality of C? So this is the continuum, and what is that? 2 to the power LF naught. This is 2 to the power LF naught, and here you have. Now, what is the operation? If you have same cardinal numbers, if you are going to multiply that, you will get the same thing. So, what is the algebra here? Algebra is C is 2 to the power LF naught. This is the definition. And LF naught times LF naught is equal to LF naught. These are the arithmetic operations in cardinal numbers. So, this. And what is nothing but C? That's the cardinality of R. So therefore, B is equivalent to R. So B has same cardinality as R. Fine. What is the use of it? I am going to do that. So this is a set of all functions. And one thing, note that your A is a subset of B. Right? You are taking all those functions from B which are continuous on Q. So I am taking those functions. So A is of course a subset of B. That means, if A is a subset of B, that implies cardinality of A is less than equal to cardinality of B, and which is nothing but C. And what is that? A was set of all continuous function from Q to R. So if I pick any real number, give me any real number A belongs to R, I can assign a function f sub A from Q to R. What is that? F of A acting on X is equal to A for all X belongs to A. So for each real number, I have a continuous function. That's constant function. Okay. So that means set of all constant functions whose domain is Q to R, I have a continuous function. F A, right? For each real number, doesn't matter which real number you are going to give, I can construct a continuous function, I mean in fact the constant function fa from q to r given by fa x equal to a for all x. And if you change the a, your function will be changed, because this function is dependent on a. That's why we written the script sub a. So how many such functions are there? How many a we have as real numbers are there? So how many continuous functions we have? As much as real numbers are there. So how many real numbers we have? Uncountable. मतलब cardinality जितनी इसकी होगी उतने मेरे पास इस type के functions मिलेंगे. इसका मतलब, and these functions are continuous. That means, therefore, cardinality of A is greater than equal to cardinality of R, which is nothing but C. Clear what? Why? Because all these functions are continuous, because these functions are constant functions. So that means in domain R Q, so f is going to be belongs to A. And if we change the A, function will change. So this is one or two. So from here, from real number, you can give a functions in A. So how many such are there? At least jitne mere paas real number. So cardinality of A is greater than equal to this. So this is your continuum. So this is again from cardinal numbers theorem. This is Pendleton-Stein's theorem. If you have two infinite series and they are following this rule, that means cardinality of A is equal to continuum, which is nothing but cardinality of real number. Therefore, A has same cardinality as of R. Yahan tak clear ho gaya? Now, so I have proved that cardinality of A is same as the cardinality of real number. Fine. But I have not proved what is the cardinality of Y. Now let's come to Y. Now I'll give a bijection. I'll give you a function from Y to A. How? Give me any function. What I'm going to do is I'm going to restrict that function to. What is f? F is in y. Y means f is a continuous function from R to R. What I'm going to do is I'm going to restrict that function to q. Fine? Okay? Now, aap kya karenge? Mera term hai. And this is well defined, right? How this is well defined? If function is continuous on R, then restricted to rational number is also continuous. And what's the definition of it? F restricted to q acting on x equal to f of x, right? You should know this kind of definition, okay? I can't do everything here. You should also work out for it. Okay. So t of equal to this. Now t is 1-1. How I can prove t is 1-1? For 1-1 is what I have to prove. Let's say t of equal to tj. That implies f restricted to q is equal to g restricted to q. What do you mean by this? This means f is equal to gx for all x belongs to q. Now, you have a continuous function on R, they agree on a Q. And what's the property of Q? Q is dense in R. So if you have a continuous function on R, if they agree on Q, on a dense set, this means they are agree everywhere, right? So, in fact, this is true in any topological space. If you have a continuous function on a space, and if they agree on a dense subset, it means they agree everywhere, okay? So that implies fx equal to gx for all x belongs to R. That implies f is equal to g. Why? Since q closure is equal to r and f equal to g on q. These are two facts and f and g are continuous. These are very very important. These are continuous kahan pe? On r. R pe. So f equal to g. So t is 1. So what I have put? T is 1. So this magnitude t from y to a is 1-1. So this is injection. That means cardinality of y is less than equal to cardinality of a. And also I know, I told you that w, since w is a subset of y, that implies cardinality of w is less than equal to cardinality of y. That means cardinality of y is less than what is the cardinality of c, and that's a continuum. W becomes c, that implies cardinality of y is equal to c, it's nothing but cardinality of real number. So y or real number ke bhi cardinality same hogi. Okay, maza aaya? So yahi ek acha sa question tha, ek non trivial option yahi ek tha, baki to fir trivial the baat mein koi jaan nahi tha. इसी में देखें हम लोगों ने कैसे कैसे कंस्ट्रक्ट किया टू मेक सेंस ऑफ डब्ल्यू. फर्स्ट आई हैव गॉन क्यू टू आर, फिर उससे जाके उसकी कार्डिनलिटी हमने कंप्यूट किया, फिर ये दिखाया कि कोई भी रियल से रियल के बीच में कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन लीजिए तो उसको हम रैशनल से भी रियल के बीच में कंटिन्यूस फंक्शन देख सकते हैं. फिर ऐसा देख के हमने ये काम किया, राइट? तो ऐसे ऐसे इस टाइप के क्वेश्चन को आपको सॉल्व करना है, इस टाइप से क्वेश्चन को आपको अप्रोच करना है. ठीक है, अब यहाँ तक हम आए हैं तो ये आ गया आपका कार्डिनलिटी. अब आते हैं जेड. ठीक है, z में आपने क्या दिया है? दिस नथिंग बट द सेट ऑफ ऑल फंक्शंस, कहां से कहां? R से. सेट ऑफ ऑल फंक्शंस फ्रॉम R टू R. सो दिस नथिंग बट दिस. एंड व्हाट इज द कार्डिनलिटी ऑफ z? अगेन बाय एलिमेंट्री सेट थ्योरी, कार्डिनलिटी ऑफ c एंड कार्डिनलिटी ऑफ c. दिस इज दिस. व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज 2 टू द पावर l f नॉट टाइम्स c. सो 2 टू द पावर l f नॉट टाइम्स c. दिस अगेन अर्थमेटिक ऑफ कार्डिनल नंबर्स, जो दोनों में सी कार्डिनलिटी ज्यादा है वो आ जाएगी सो टू द पास सी, एंड व्हिच इज ऑफ कोर्स ग्रेटर देन सी व्हिच इज नथिंग बट कार्डिनलिटी ऑफ रियल वर्ल्ड. तो इसका मतलब जेड की कार्डिनलिटी रियल नंबर की कार्डिनलिटी से बड़ी है. और इसका जो नोटेशन है उसको बोलते हैं LF2. दीज आर सम नंबर, दीज आर कंप्लीटिंग नंबर्स एंड ऑल दैट. ओके, आई डोंट वांट टू गो ऑन दैट. इफ आई गो इट विल टेक 2-3 डेज. ओके, सो लीव इट दैट. बट दिस इज दिस टू द पावर सी समहाउ यू कैन से दिस इज द पावर सेट ऑफ आर. एंड पावर सेट की जो कार्डिनलिटी होती है वो सेट की कार्डिनलिटी से ज़्यादा होती है. कैंटोस का थ्योरम है. ओके, सो दिस, सो इसकी कार्डिनलिटी रियल नंबर के बराबर नहीं. सो हमें क्या क्या सही ऑप्शंस मिले, डब्ल्यू की, एक्स की और वाई की. इसकी जो कार्डिनलिटी है वो रियल नंबर की कार्डिनलिटी के साथ बराबर है, जबकि जेड की वो नहीं. देख लेते हैं ऑप्शन. ओनली डब्ल्यू, ओनली डब्ल्यू एक्स, नो. ओनली डब्ल्यू एक्स जेड, नो. ओनली डब्ल्यू एक्स वाई जेड, नो. सो इसमें से एक भी ऑप्शन करेक्ट नहीं है. और ये एग्जैक्टली CSIR का ऑप्शन है. ये 2013 या 12 का क्वेश्चन है. फॉरगेट, बट आपको आंसर आना चाहिए. लोग क्या करते हैं, बस बना दिए, हो गया, ऑप्शन टिक मारे चले गए. मत कीजिए ऐसा. ऐसा करने से आपका नहीं बेसिक. बेसिक अगर कमजोर है इट्स नॉट ए क्राइम. अगर आपका बेसिक नहीं उतना अच्छा है, आप उसमें कंफर्टेबल नहीं है, वो आपका क्राइम नहीं है. ट्रस्ट मी, कोई बात नहीं है. सबका सब कुछ अच्छा नहीं हो सकता. अगर सबको सब कुछ आता तब तो वो तो फिर भगवान हो जाते हैं. सो डोंट वरी, समथिंग इज हियर. दिस इज ओनली फॉर यू गाइज. आई वॉन्ट टू मेक यू कम्फर्टेबल इन मैथमेटिक्स. तो ये चीज़ को देखिए एक बार, सोचिए इस संबंध में और आइए मिलकर सीखते हैं. मिलकर सीखते हैं गणित, कुछ करते हैं, कुछ मज़ेदार चीज़ करते हैं लाइफ में, कुछ ऐसा करते हैं कि अपने आप पे प्राउड हो जाए. मैथ्स को भी आप पे प्राउड हो जाएगा, हाँ भैया क्या मैथ्स बनाए. तो ऐसा कुछ होना चाहिए. और चीज़ मैं करूँगा, डोंट वरी. ओके, सो ऐसे ऐसे धीरे धीरे आपको कॉन्सेप्ट को अप्लाई करना है, अपनी चीज़ों को बेसिक बेसिक आइडियाज़ को डालना है, सेट थ्योरी पे कमांड रखना. अगर आपको सेट थ्योरी नहीं आता तो क्वेश्चन ही नहीं आप बना सकते. बेसिक क्वेश्चन सर, तो आपको थोड़ा सा ध्यान देना चाहिए, उस पर वर्कआउट करना चाहिए. एंड होप विल मीट ऑन समडे. एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल. ओके, एंड लाइक माई फेसबुक पेज. एंड वन मोर थिंग, जो भी नीडी स्टूडेंट्स हैं इंडिया में, जो आपके भी दोस्त हैं आस पास, जो लगता है कि एडुकेशन अफोर्ड नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, उनको आप ये वीडियो जरूर शेयर कीजिए. उनको जो वीडियो दिखाइए ताकि उन्हें पता चले कि मैथ्स ऐसे किया जाता है, ऐसे समझना है, ये सारे स्कोप्स हैं. ये वीडियो उन्हीं लोगों के लिए है, यू नो. तो थोड़ा सा इसमें आपका मुझे सपोर्ट बहुत ज़रूरी है, अदरवाइज़ फिर कोई भी नहीं होगा. और मुझे पता है कि आप भी इतना ही नोबल सोचते हैं जितना मैं सोचता हूँ. तो बस वो चीज़ को थोड़ा सा कीजिए ताकि एकदम बच्चों तक पहुँचा दीजिए. बच्चों के बीच में पहुँच जाना चाहिए. जो भी नीडी स्टूडेंट्स हैं उसके अंदर चले जाना चाहिए, उसको भी मैथमेटिक्स एकदम आना चाहिए. ओके, तो उस चीज़ कीजिए, पढ़ें और पढ़ाएं, बहुत ज़रूरी है, करते रहें. और उसमें मैं आपको एकदम साथ हूँ, कदम से कदम मिला के चल रहा हूँ आपके साथ. मैं आपको कभी भी निराश नहीं करूँगा गणित में, ये मेरा आपको प्रॉमिस है. जब तक हूँ आपके लिए मैथमेटिक्स में करता रहूँ. ओके, सो वर्क हार्ड ऑन दैट, बी कॉन्फिडेंट एंड होप विल मीट समडे. एंड बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका मेरा वीडियो देखने के लिए. इट रियली मीन्स अ लॉट फॉर मी. थैंक यू.